ngome za jeshi ya jeshi ya Jamhuri ya Demokrasia ya Kongo.
It is day four of fierce fighting between M23 rebels and Congo government soldiers. Bunagana remains in the hands of the rebels, and today another strategic town of Ruchuru has been captured after tough battle between M23 rebels and thousands of government troops. Ruchuru is one of the major strongholds of the Congolese army that left about 50 of their commanders captured by the rebels.
Jeshi la serikali tunaimaliza imekufa, hawana tena nguvu ya kupigana, ndio raia sasa naye atatia haki zake mbele.
So far the areas in the hands of the rebels include Bunagana, Murambi, Chengerero, Gako, Bweza and Busanza among others.
Na ingine imekimbia, haina morali ya kupigana.
NTV Today in an exclusive interview spoke with M23 rebel commander Colonel Sultan Makenga for the first time since they split from the Congolese government 1.5 years ago. I posed him the question as to why they are continuing to advance through Congo.
So, unajua adui akiwa karibu yako kila mara na kusumbua, tulitaka tusukume adui mbali zaidi ili tuweze kukaa raia wakae kwa amani. Yani bombs za adui kila mara zinaumiza raia.
This gate to Chengerero was yesterday in the hands of the rebels, and it is the checkpoint for everyone and every vehicle that crosses to Congo en route to Ruchiri, deep inside Congo. But today, it remains wide open to everyone.
Chengere. This is Chengerero town that was once a stronghold for the government forces but was captured by the M23 rebels yesterday after serious fighting. Most of the residents fled the places, but they are slowly returning home. The soldiers who are paying allegiance to the sitting government of Congo took off to the other side, that is Ruchiri, about 13 kilometers from here.
We continue towards Ruchiri, checking on most of the bases that were occupied by the Congolese army. For any sovereign country, it is not easy for the lean forces to surrender without trying to defend themselves against the enemy. Some choose to die while others withdraw, giving the enemy a leeway. This is the bridge in Rankuba which government troops that crossed to Uganda claimed had been broken by the rebels. And it is the reason 500 of them fled to Uganda due to lack of human support from the Congo. About 50 meters from the bridge are some of the 37 shells which government forces used against M23, who were based in the rugged hills. This kind of gun is particularly dangerous, as it leaves many civilian casualties if the enemy is hiding within the community. But government troops took off with the gun and were later overpowered from Ruchuru. But where is the man Bosco Ntaganda, which is alleged started this rebel group?
Bosco yana convention zake na government. Rais Kabila alikubali kumu protect. Sisi hatuko na jenerali Bosco na hatutakuwa naye.
The rebels say they are increasingly energized every day as they advance in the rebels say they are increasingly energized every day as they advance in this huge country, which they say has been betrayed by their own government. But if peace talks between the rebels and the government was to take place, who should head these talks?
Tunaomba mheshima Mkapa, mheshima Obasanjo na wengine wote wanaohusika na kurudisha amani katika ulimwengu wakuje waambie serikali ya Kinshasa irudi kwenye meza ya mazungumzo.
According to the sources, today the Congo government tried to bombard the rebels for about 10 minutes but flew back due to the immense rebel fire. It is alleged that 3 planes were hit before the capture of Bunagana border last week. For now, the rebels' eyes remain firmly focused on the ball, and that they are ready to overthrow the current government if a substantial agreement is not reached. Sudil Biaruhanga, NTV, Bunagana.